Deuteronomy 6. Deuteronomy 6. Simply titled, Take the Lord With You. Not familiar, not sure how familiar you are with a pilot as they prepare to pilot a plane to leave from one place with the hope and prayer, amen, of reaching another destination. They go through a checklist. They go through a checklist, and it's a it's quite a sizable checklist. They go through and make sure that everything is where it needs to be and functioning on the ground prior to getting up into the air the way it should be functioning on the ground. Or maybe you yourself, or you know someone who, as they are getting ready for work, they make sure they have everything in order. Many of us, we'll leave out the house and go back in the house. And we'll leave back out the house and go back in the house. And after 5 or 6 times of going in and out of the house, we finally have secured everything that we need in order to take our journey and head off to work. Father, just talk about myself, amen. See, this, the older I get, the more I have to go back into the house. And sometimes I even go back in the house to get what I went back in the house to get. But I'll pick up something. And then I get back in the truck or car and remember what I really want to get, and I go back and get that. And then pick up something else I may need. Amen. But what we're doing is, as we are preparing and heading off for a journey, we are trying to secure everything that we need, everything that's going to be beneficial to us throughout that day. And for a few minutes this evening, I want to talk to us from the subject, take the Lord with you. Before you leave the house, amen, before you start your day, you need to have thought of what you would do that day. And too many times we overlook taking the Lord with us.
Amen.
We get our keys, we get our wallet, we get our purses, we get our glasses, we get our other keys, we get our lunch, we get our drink to drive to work on, amen, we get all these things, but we, many times we go off and we forget about the Lord.
Amen.
And the reason we forget about the Lord is that we start to think that we are doing everything by ourselves. And God cautioned Israel about just that thing. He said, I don't want you to forget about me. When you get out and start doing things, doing your daily deeds and tasks and duties and all those things, don't forget about me. So I want to encourage us, just remind us of just a few minutes this evening, that we ought to take the Lord with us. Right. In Deuteronomy 6, beginning at verse number 1, it says, now these are the commandments, the statutes, and the judgment the Lord your God commands to teach you, that you might do them in the land whether you go to possess it. That thou mightest fear the Lord thy God, to keep all his statutes and his commandments which I command thee, thou and thy son and thy son's son, all the days of thy life, and that thy days may be prolonged. He says, hear therefore, Israel, and observe to do it, that it may be well with thee, that you may increase mightily, as the Lord God of thy fathers hath promised thee, in the land that floweth with milk and honey. He says, hear, O Israel, the Lord your God is one Lord, and thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thine heart, with all thy soul, with all thy might. These words which I command thee this day shall be in thine heart. And he says, and thou shalt teach them diligently unto thy children, and shall talk of them. He said, here's when you do it. You shall talk of them when thou sittest in thine house, when thou walkest by the way, when thou liest down, and when thou risest up. And thou shalt bind them for a sign upon thine hand, and they shall be as frontlets between thine eyes, and thou shalt write them upon the posts of thy house and on thy gates. And it shall be when the Lord thy God shall have brought thee into the land which he sware unto thy fathers, to Abraham, Isaac, and to Jacob, to give thee great and goodly cities which thou buildest not, and houses full of all good things which thou fillest not, and wells deep which thou diggest not, vineyards and olive trees which thou plantest not, when thou shalt have eaten and be full, like some of you all this evening, amen. He says, then, here's the problem. once we got to a certain point in life, here's the problem that God foresaw. And we can even see it in our own lives sometimes. Once we have reached a certain level or reached a certain pinnacle or a certain goal or achieved something that was on our to-do list, it says, then beware, lest thou forget the Lord. What Lord? In their case, the one which brought thee forth out of the land of Egypt from the house of bondage. Don't ever forget where you came from, amen?
Amen.
It's too easy sometimes to forget where you came from, and people sometimes they try to forget where they came from. I believe it's a danger associated with that. Not saying you got to dwell on it all the time, but don't ever forget where you came from. He said, I don't want you to forget, Israel. And in order to make sure that you don't forget, and that your children don't forget, and their children, their children's children, and generations on, I want you to take me with you. When you walk, take me with you. When you sit down, take me with you. When you lay down, take me with you. When you get up, take me with you. So there should not be a time, amen, in our lives, if we truly respect and appreciate what God has done for us, there should not be a time in our lives when He is not on our minds.
Amen.
Some of the things that we can do. And we notice He said for them to write it on their hands, that these were symbolic, physical reminders. Put it between the fronts of their eyes, on the doorposts of their homes. All these their physical reminders, there are little things that we can do as children of God to help remind us. Help us to grow and be spiritually strong and productive. Write something down. Write a scripture down on a sticky note, amen? On a memory card. Write it down on a calendar during the day and just focus on that every chance you get. It's okay to do that. And when you get older, amen, like I am, you have to write stuff down anyway. You have to write yourself a note, then you write yourself another note, and you put that note in your pocket. So when you pull that note out, it reminds you to look at the note in the other pocket, amen? So you start writing things down to help you to focus on the Lord.
Amen.
How about memorizing a scripture? Meditate on a certain scripture and go out throughout that entire week and throughout that entire day and meditate and memorize that scripture. Something that's really precious to you. Take the Lord with you, amen.
Amen.
How about singing? You ought to have a song on your heart. Good song would be Take the Lord with you, amen.
Amen.
I think that would be a good reminder for us. Before we leave the house, I want to take the Lord with me. Sing the song and know that you have Him in your heart. So singing the words of scripture based on psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs, songs of praise, singing those.
Amen.
Take the Lord with you. That's all I want to remind us of this evening, to encourage us to take the Lord with us everywhere we go.
Amen.
And when I say everywhere we go, we take the Lord with us, just maybe we won't go some places that we go. I can't see you pulling up in the car on the parking lot of the casino. So I'm not talking, you all take the Lord, amen. That don't go together. Pulling up at the club late at night, you younger folks. I'll say about 35 and younger, they still go on a business club. So once you get 36, you get too tired to be done business club, amen. Pull up on the club late at night, on the parking lot, you don't see you jumping out of the car talking about taking the Lord, but you're probably back in the car, amen. That's a good song, though. Take the Lord with you. And let me give you this as I close. I got Jesus on my mind. My mind on Jesus. So that's how we sing that song. I woke up this morning with my mind to stay on Jesus.
Amen.
How about we go into the day, I got Jesus on my mind and my mind on Jesus. That's all I want to say to you this evening. I want to encourage you. As we go throughout this week, let us try something a little bit different. Let us write ourselves notes, scripture reminders, Let us memorize scripture. Let us meditate on scripture. Let us sing psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melodies in our hearts to the Lord. Take the Lord with you. If you're this evening, you're not a child of God. You came here. When we leave, I want you to take the Lord with you. How do you do that, preacher? By being obedient to the gospel of Jesus Christ. Jesus died on the cross and was buried and rose again the third day. When one hears that story, you have to be willing to believe it. You're willing to have a changed mind. That's repentance. You're willing to confess with your mouth that they believe Jesus Christ is the Son of God. He didn't have the sins washed away, water away, baptism, rise from all the people's life, be added to the body of Christ. It's the church of Christ. It's his bride. It's his wife. He's coming back for her. He's coming back for her. Don't you want to be part of her? Don't you want to be a member of her? Don't you want to be in her when he comes back? And if your faith unto death is out, give you a crown of life. Take the Lord with you. You came here without it, but don't leave here without it. It's your decision, it's your choice. Nobody's going to make it, nobody's going to force you. But we want you to do that because we must all stand before the judgment seat of Christ. Take the Lord with you, don't leave here without it. If you're even your child of God falling by the wayside, whatever the reason, come back home. Whatever reason you've got to take the Lord with you, and you went out and did something, take the Lord with you, see? Child of God, we want you to come. If you're not a child of God, we want you to come. But because we want to take the Lord with us, amen. We want to take the Lord with us. I think that's number two in our goals. As we stand and sing the song, we hear it.
Take the Lord with you. Take him with you now. Everywhere you go, you gotta take.